All right, guys. WMAP back here again. Sorry for the technical difficulty, but as I told you, I have the one and only Susan Urban on the line right now. Guys, my pleasure, my honor to bring to WMAP Miss Susan Urban. Susan, how are you today?
I am excellent. How are you today?
It is terrific to hear your voice, even though it's on a telephone, and that's kind of what we got working right now, so that's terrific. How are you doing, Susan?
I'm great. Let's just work it, Casey.
You got it.
Let's work with what we got, right?
It's true. So Susan, look, I love what you do because I'm as you know, I've told you before, I've told on here. I'm a guy, I have, panic, they say it's panic disorder, I have anxiety, but you found a way to help people with anxiety, and it's not what normally they just hand you a bunch of pills and send you on your way. Tell me what's different about your approach.
Well, yeah, you bring up such an important point, Casey. In the past, people they've tried everything, you know, medication, therapy, acupuncture, massage, you know, salt caves, this and that, and none of that really helps you completely overcome anxiety. Those are just band-aids. And people with anxiety, just like you have described, they have panic disorders. They worry all the time. They think about the worst case scenario. There's a lot of overwhelm. They feel stressed out a lot. They worry about the future. They worry about the health. There's a lot of self-doubt. So there's so much suffering with this condition that comes along with it. And a lot of times people really don't know how to get out of that loop. It's like a vicious cycle that you get up in the morning and it starts up again, and then you go to sleep at night. You can barely, you know, a lot of people have sleeping problems with this condition. So what I do is I help them in a natural way. Everybody has the resources inside of themselves. Everybody has the tools to help them overcome this condition called anxiety. And really, what I do is mind coaching. I help people transform and change their subconscious mind. That's really where a lot of the programming is taking place. That the stuff that we're consciously not aware of. And so I work with people on that level so that they can really understand themselves in a different way. And this is not something that is taught in school, not something that's taught to you know, medical society. So what I really do with people is I'm a master coach in NLP, timeline therapy, and hypnosis. And those are my tools that I implement, and I have a 100% success rate with my clients.
Incredible. Susan, is it mostly men, or is it mostly women, or is it split right down the middle, or is that not even a factor?
It really isn't a factor. Again, what you bring up is just so interesting, because it doesn't matter what race you are, it doesn't matter what age, it doesn't matter what profession, how old you are, you know, anxiety seems to be affecting everybody. Starting it, I've even heard some of my clients and friends tell me that kids at 5-6 years old have anxiety. Up until I've worked with my oldest client was probably 62 years old. She had a fear of retiring. She felt so insecure about herself, constantly worried about, oh my God, I'm not making enough money. I want to retire anyway. And she has had anxiety for the majority of her life and didn't really know how to get out of that. So yes, it's definitely, currently I seem to be having more male clients, and I don't know if that's because a lot of the men that I work with are the breadwinners. They have incredibly a lot of responsibilities. They are the man of the household, whatever you want to call
it.
So I think that they just feel that they're constantly putting out fires. They're always wanting the best for their family, wanting the best for their team, but they forget about themselves. And it's like, how much longer can you continue in this vicious cycle? You know, you got to take care of yourself first before you can take care of everybody in your life. So
yeah, and that's one of the things that you are a big proponent of. You're a big proponent of putting yourself first, and a lot of us don't do that, right?
Absolutely. You know, they say, I mean, I know when we fly, most of us don't pay attention to when the flight attendant gives you the safety instructions, but it comes down to put on the oxygen mask on yourself first. And what does that look like in your life? You know, where are you stressed? Where do you need help? Why are you overwhelmed? Why are you procrastinating? Why are you biting your nails? you know, what's with the racing heart? If that's what you're experiencing, that means, you know, you are not taking care of yourself the way you deserve to take care of yourself. And self-care doesn't mean you need to spend 10 hours at the spa. Not at all. I don't believe in work-life balance, but I do believe in take care of yourself first, and then you can take care of everybody else easily.
Gotcha. And you said before that a lot of this is rooted in the subconscious. Can you expand on that?
Yes. So the way I love to explain that is, you know, when we're kids, between the ages of 0 to 6 years old, is when we're like sponges. Whatever is being told to us, whatever we are being taught, whatever we're being instructed, our mind, which at that point is really more like the subconscious mind, takes it all in. At that age, we do not have the ability to differentiate, is this right or is this wrong? Do I believe this or not? Does this work for me or not? So this programming gets installed, technical term, installed into us. Mm-hmm. And for example, you know, little girls should be good girls. Boys need to be tough. You need to toughen up, kid. Come on, you're strong. You stop crying. Or, hey, the world out there is dangerous. Well, we're the Joneses. We've always been broke. Oh, we're you know, oh, your first name is Mary. That means you're going to be a drunk for the rest of your life. So stuff like that is, as a kid, we hear, we pick up, we learn. And then as we get older, that programming is running us. It sort of subliminally, right, subconsciously runs us, unless we become aware of, because now, look, I work with a Harvard graduate, 53 years old. He comes to my office, he goes, I am lost. I don't know what I want. I don't know who I am. And where am I going with this? So he really was told at a very young age that you have to succeed. You know, we are, again, we're the Joneses. We have to make it big in this world. You have to remember who you are, and if you don't succeed, you're a loser. And so he's been hearing this his whole life, and now he feels all this pressure. But the whole thing is, he doesn't believe in driving a Maserati. He doesn't care about the country club. He wants to live, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So if you don't explore, hey, wait, who am I? What do I want? What is not serving me? You know, what do I not believe? You know, at 5 years old, we believed in Santa Claus. Great, that was useful when you're five. But that's not useful when you're 52, right?
Right.
But, I mean, this is such a stupid example, but that's the point. We are being told and taught so many things at that age that we just continue carrying forward. But sometimes, not just sometimes, we need to become aware of these thoughts, of these emotions that are running underneath. And that's all in your subconscious mind.
Mm. And how much of it is, or is any of it, unresolved issues that bring us to have these panic attacks, or the anxiety, the feeling of dread? Is that something that we
exactly.
just haven't worked out in the past? Is that what it is, some of it?
Exactly. You are absolutely right. A lot of these are unresolved issues. Now, it could be trauma from the past, or drama, you know, like, it could just be some experiences that were negative, or it could be just some history, some things that happened in the past that to this day you feel guilty about, or you feel resentment, or, oh my God, she hurt me so badly, I'll never talk to her, or a lot of anger, which builds up to rage, or a lot of sadness that turns into depression. And by the way, anxiety, really the root emotion of anxiety is fear. So at one point in your life, your body learned how to manage this dramatic situation through making anxiety. And now, you are still operating with this old operating system of, we have to make anxiety every time the body experiences stress. And that's not useful, because it wears you out. It zaps your energy. Really, you see the world in black and white, you know, it zaps everything out of you. So having anxiety is very draining, and it causes sleep deprivation and, you know, a lot more negative emotions. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. And can also a big event, like for instance, like when you left Austria, I believe you were like 21 and you had like a suitcase and you didn't know anybody and you came over here. That's something that will give you anxiety. Is there a difference between being really nervous and kind of feeling like you run over your head, or is that anxiety? What's the line right there?
So you said that, oh, when you came here at 21, you had a suitcase, and that can cause anxiety. It depends who you are. For me, it caused a lot of excitement.
Okay.
But when a dog bit me, that caused me a lot of anxiety, and that caused me to be fearful of dogs for my whole life, which now I have a German Shepherd. So we got over that. But you see, so we don't know what that trauma may have been in the past that caused the anxiety. And that's the kind of work I do as well when I work with my clients. We go personally into, hey, let's go back and find out. Let's get rid of that root cause, you know, so that you don't have to be scared of dogs again. Or really, number one, fear public speaking, right? How useful is it to have fear of public speaking? If you're a successful professional who has a lot to say, if you could get up on stage and if you could tell the world about this newest technology or what you can do, how useful is public speaking for you? It's not. Let's get rid of that so that you can have the impact in your life that you want to have and that people deserve to hear you. So public speaking is just one of those anxieties, you know, right?
Mm-hmm. I thought that was a great example, and that kind of made it kind of clear for me when you said that about the difference between excitement and, you know, an event happening, such as being bitten by a dog. Do you think a lot of us are quick to not really be in touch with our emotions, kind of all of a sudden going right to anxiety or right to depression when it could be something positive?
You're absolutely right. And understanding, you're brilliant. Understanding your emotions is incredibly helpful in learning how to navigate yourself, how to respond to certain situations in your life, like stress. Stress is a given. Like, are you kidding me? Nobody can take your challenges, your problems, or the stress away from you. But what you can learn is when you are in that situation again, now with these new tools, learning how to use your emotions instead of having them use you, and learning how to think differently, how to look at the situation so that you can manage through it to your advantage instead of the situation managing you and tossing you around like being thrown around by some waves in the ocean, right?
Mm-hmm.
What if you could learn how to stand up to that and surf in that and dance in the rain instead of running away from it?
Wow. Guys, if you're tuning in right now, I'm speaking with the one and only Susan Urban. Susan Urban is a lead writer on Simply Amazing Women, which will be out in November or December. And we're so excited to have her on that. But also, she's a transformation coach. And to get more information, go over to SusanUrbanFitness.com, and you can get more information there. Susan, tell me, who is the best candidate for you? And how do people know when it's time that they got to get in touch with you? I mean, who should get in touch with you? And what doesn't it have to be like?
So my favorite client and the one I absolutely love to work with is the business leader, business owner who is completely overwhelmed, stressed out, procrastinates all the time, worries about everything all day long, puts out fires left and right, wants to show up for his family, wants to be more present in his life, wants to enjoy himself, but simply doesn't know how, you know, can't sleep at night. And a lot of times their health is suffering as well. They might already be overweight. They might have high blood pressure, you know, and so that's the person, that the person who has a lot at stake. If you're the breadwinner in your family, if you are the leader of your team, if you're the owner of the business and you know you're really good at what you do, but this anxiety somehow is just crushing you every day and it doesn't help you move forward. So that is who I love to work with. Because I love to work with people who are driven, who are hungry, who want to make a difference, whether it's in their career, in their family, in the life, I don't care. But somebody who is absolutely passionate about moving forward and doesn't know how. And typically working with me is usually about a 5 to 6 week process.
That's
it? We're done.
Wow.
That's it. When I, 5 to 6 weeks, the thing is, a lot of people enjoy continuing working with me after they overcome anxiety because I know I can help them. They learn that I can help them become more successful, increase their income, learn how to be more persuasive, more influential with their client in their business. So then they're like curious about that, and then they want to learn more about those techniques, which is all NLP and hypnosis, believe it or not. But really overcoming anxiety, it's 5-6 weeks.
Wow, that's incredible. Guys, Susan Urban is who I'm speaking with right now. And my question for you, Susan, is what about people who have been diagnosed with anxiety disorder, panic disorder, and they're already on medication? Now, I know that people can't just stop taking medication. How does that work? Do you work in hand-to-hand with a doctor, or do you see if they're supposed to taper off? How does that work?
Great question, Casey. I'm so glad you asked about that. So I always tell my clients, I am not a therapist, I'm a coach. I do not interfere with the doctor-patient relationship. It's the doctor is the one who put you on medication, and it is your choice, responsibility, whatever you want to call it, to communicate with your doctor and ask him what is the best approach for me on how to, because I'm not into chemistry, it's not my thing. And so I always leave it up to the patient, which for me, is, of course, is a client. But I leave it up to my client, and I'm very clear about them. I said, look, if you're on medication, I know for sure that you have the ability to come off medication. But when the right time is and how, that is not up to me to decide. That is something that you get to decide. Talk to your doctor. I'm happy to speak to your doctor about what I do, but I do not get in the middle of taking people off medication or putting them on. That's not my expertise.
Yeah. I'm glad you said that, because I'm sure a lot of people are like, well, I'm already taking Xanax, so how can I? And it takes a little while, I guess. But that's a question for the doctor that put you on it, right?
Yeah, and I can tell you again with 100% confidence that every single one of my clients who has been on medication before they started working with me is no longer on medication after again, maybe not immediately because I don't interfere with that,
right,
but they certainly no longer take medication
It's incredible, Susan, because they usually prescribe these benzodiazepines, the benzos they call them, and that is the only one that can kill you besides alcohol if you just stop taking it.
Exactly. Yeah. And that's the reason, right? Yeah. And what I always tell my clients is have you looked at the side effects? Mm. And is that what you want for the rest of your life? Mm. Paying the price to pay for these side effects, especially if there's an alternative. I have nothing. I mean, please, I have a lot of respect for the medical community. What they do is like freaking ninja. I can't even put my little finger on that. Really, I mean, it's incredible. But I have a lot of friends who are therapists, who are doctors. I have a friend who's a neurologist, MD, and they all confess to me that the medical industry does not know how to help people completely overcome anxiety. They give out band-aids.
Right.
And so therefore I say, you know, medicine, side effects, especially if you don't need it, like, come on.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to be on medicine.
And yet you have if I have this correctly, you have a 100% success rate.
Yes.
That's incredible. I
have worked with people all over the world. Because I have one program that is an online, it's a 6-week anxiety solution online program that no matter where you're in the world, you can take it. You still have access to me because I do the coaching in the program, obviously. But what I love about that program is that no matter where you are in the world, you can do this. If you speak English and if you're human and you have anxiety, then you can take this course. Those are really the only requirements. And you know, you have to want to overcome anxiety, obviously. So I am accessible to anybody who really wants to completely overcome anxiety.
That's awesome. Guys,
and even the people who took the online, so this is what I love to share, is the people who are taking the online course, within the first week, they're like, oh my God, I'm a different person. I am calmer. I see things within week one.
Incredible. That's awesome. Susan Urban, guys, is who I've been speaking with, and she can be reached at susanurbanfitness.com. She, you heard what we've been talking about the past half hour, and you also know she's going to be in Simply Amazing Women. She's definitely one of the world's most amazing people. And Susan, I thank you so much for coming on and helping so many people like you do.
Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity, Casey, to share my message. And that's really, what a privilege. Thank you so very, very much, everybody, and especially Casey.
You got to come in live the next one here. Susan Urban, awesome. Great to hear from you, and great appearance. We'll talk to you soon. God bless, Susan.
Thank you. Best to you all.
You too. Disaster. We bow down and worship him now.